Congratulations on selling your first porcelain slab job, but now you need to find a score and snap system that's easily available and easy to use. So with that being said, we're gonna look at the Rubi Slim Cutter System. The Rubi Slim System Cutter comes in this black nylon carrying bag. Inside the four outside pockets, you will find all the necessary accessories to set up and cut your slabs. You will find two suction cups to secure the track guides, two adjustable pincer breakers, the scoring carriage, and a 4mm hex handle for tightening the nuts used in the system. In the larger section of the bag are the three sections of track guides. This particular cutter is designed for slabs 1/8 of an inch to 3/8 of an inch in thickness, or 3.5 millimeters to 8 millimeters. Rubi states that the system is designed for slabs that are 10 feet by 4 feet. Can you cut slabs bigger than that? Yes, but you need to think ahead and you need to be patient. It does take some additional skill to make larger slabs work on the table and cutter system. Rubi does make available an additional track piece that you can order as an a la carte item. The track guides are simple to assemble and very lightweight. On their underside are two parallel silicone cords to protect against possible scratching of the slab surface. Each section of the track measures just over 43 inches in length. When all three sections are attached together, you can cut a slab no longer than 122 inches. To assemble the track, use the hex key provided in your bag. Loosen the four nuts on the top slider bar so that it easily slides up and down the track. Flip the guide over and loosen the two nuts on the smaller bar. Move the two track pieces together, lining up the slider bars. Move the bars evenly between the two guides and tighten down the nuts until they are snug. One word of caution, over-tightening the bars together may damage the track guides and warp them. At the same time, you don't want to under-tighten them so that the nuts might actually fall out and be lost. So before you've cleaned up your job site and put away your tools, make sure that all of the tightening nuts are accounted for. Once you have attached your desired amount of guides together, place the two suction cups inside the groove and twist the bolt to secure them. You want to place them equally apart from the edge of the piece to be cut to stabilize the system. After some experience working with the cutting system, you may decide that the suction cups are not needed. The scoring carriage or cutter is a simple and easy to use scoring head built around the idea of palm pressure. You have four bearings attached at the factory, a knob to rest your hand atop for pressure, and the cutting wheel. No springs, no levers, that's it. Full disclosure, I've been a user of the Rubi Slim Cutter since 2018. My unit was in the 8,000s. The one that I'm using from the Rubi rep today is in the 18,000s. So in between those 3 years, they've sold 10,000 more units. It's a reliable tool. It's simple, it's basic, low maintenance. In fact, the only thing I've had to maintain on my cutter has been getting a new cutting wheel. Replaced it just two times in those years that I've been using it. For maintenance on the guides, you really just need a dry rag. Wipe down any dust or particles. Now that you have a clean guide system assembled, make sure you have a table within tolerance for flatness, and then put a piece of porcelain on the table to be cut. Mark your cuts and line up your guide. The guide should offset roughly 3/8 of an inch from the track to the cutting blade. However, I would suggest lining up and checking both sides of your cut before clamping the suction cups down. Once you are sure of the guide position, secure the suction cups. Take your cutter and place approximately 2 to 3 inches inwards from the edge. Push down and pull back towards the edge of the slab. This motion ensures a strong score line at the start of your cut. Now, evenly and firmly push down on the cutter, moving it at a consistent speed down the track. You should hear a paper shredding sound. Make sure that wherever you are scoring is properly supported by one of the aluminum bars on the table. If you don't, you risk having a bad score line that might crack the piece or potentially crack your entire slab, and that's an expensive mistake to make. After we score the slab, we need to pull the score line out and away from the table to pop it. Use the pincers provided by Rubi and put the yellow portion under the slab and evenly place the black plastic atop each side of your score line. Squeeze the handle until you hear a pop or see the tile separate. Smaller pieces might split completely apart when using the pincers, so hold and support the tile as necessary. It is recommended that two people do this together, with each using the pincers on the opposite sides of the slab at the same time. For larger pieces, support the overhang while you position the cut line at the edge of your table. Use the edge as a breaker and push down while keeping the slab stable. This might involve two people, and over time you will get more skilled. For smaller strips, begin working the split down the slab, but be careful and wear your gloves. The Rubi Slim Cutter is a simple to use and effective tool. However, it does have its limitations. When cutting smaller strips, it's difficult and somewhat awkward to have to break them off by hand. This is especially awkward when doing this solo. So I'm going to use a T-bar to help with splitting these small strips. Regardless, find a technique that works for you and is complementary to the Rubi system. One of the benefits for me of the Rubi system is that if ever you're missing a component, if you need to pick something up in a pinch, you can easily find it available in stores. Floor & Decor, Dal Tile, those are just some of the main distributors that carry the Rubi product line. Pricing for the Slim Cutter sits around $400 to $450 for the tooling shown. For a first purchase or one you want to keep for emergencies, it is fantastic. The tool gives you a clean cut and is super easy to maintain. I love how easy the Rubi is to go from short to medium and to long cuts in just a few seconds. The fact that you can store the cutter in a small space and not have to worry about the unit becoming unaligned is a great relief. One feature that is quite interesting to me is that the track guide also supports the TC125 circular saw system. Check out our video on that, plus our review of the Rubi Slim System table in the links below. As mentioned earlier in the video, the design of the Slim Cutter has not changed a whole lot since I bought mine in 2018. That is about to change. Sometime during the end of 2021 or early 2022, a new Slim Cutter Plus model will be released with a new cutter, more suction cups, and a brand new design for the splitter. This is said to work potentially with 12mm, and I'm looking forward to testing it out once released. Thanks for watching our review of the Rubi Slim Cutter system. I hope you were able to gain a better understanding of how the Rubi cutter works, how it's beneficial to you as an installer, and overall, how it will improve your job installations. Now make sure to like and subscribe and stay notified as far as new videos that we have coming out regarding GPTP tool installation systems. And as always, you're not a pro unless you know.